Life of Saint Celestine the First. Celestine was born at an unknown time in late 4th century in the Italian province of Campania to a Roman father, whose name was Priscus. It is said that he lived in Milan under the tutelage of Saint Ambrose. In 416 AD, he traveled to Rome and was ordained a deacon. In 422, upon the blessed repose of Pope Saint Boniface I, Celestine was chosen to ascend the throne of Peter with the approval of the entire city. Celestine's first official act as Patriarch of Rome was to condemn a novationist African bishop who was found guilty of a number of grave abuses against the church and the people. In his fight against the novationists, the Pope emphasized that the forgiveness should not be refused to dying sinners who sincerely requested it. Perhaps Pope Saint Celestine's greatest spiritual accomplishment was his zealous and fiery defense of Western Orthodoxy against the threat of Nestorius' blasphemous heresies against the Theotokos. He claimed that she shouldn't be referred to as the Theotokos, she who gave birth to God, but Christotokos, she who gave birth to Christ, for he claimed that flesh cannot give birth to divinity. It was Saint Celestine who initially anathematized Nestorius' teachings, based on the reports made by Saint Cyril of Alexandria, and has sent legates to the Council of Ephesus, which has finally pronounced Nestorius' condemnation and excommunication. Pope Saint Celestine's final notable official act was sending of Saint Patrick to Ireland in 432. In so doing, Celestine allowed for the striking of a mighty blow against paganism, and secured countless victories for the Kingdom of God through shining contributions for the faith of British Christians. Pope Saint Celestine reposed on 1st of August 432, a couple of days after sending Saint Patrick to Ireland. Saint Celestine was a fiery defender of Orthodoxy and tradition. His zeal in the upholding the canons of the Church is exemplary, going as far as to censor priests who dressed like monks and who started wearing vestments which would distinguish them from the laity. He considers silence in the face of heresy and sin to be one of the worst vices that a man can commit. By his prayers, may Christ our God grant us at least a crumb of his fervor, that we may all behold the face of God for all of eternity, unto the ages of ages. Amen.